head bed, a salon sink, head and neck support. Adrian, a professional UK hairdresser for over 28 years, will demonstrate the best way to use the head bed. After 3 months of constant use, Adrian is now a passionate advocate of this new safety device for the neck of his clients. Wipe the basin dry before placing the headbed on it. Wet the suction cups with some clean water and align the head platform in the center of the neck curve. Choose the adapter that best fits your depth of basin. 97% of your technique stays exactly the same, as well as your access to the hair. Only a tiny area under the head is resting on the supportive platform, and you can easily work around that. Your client will be used to holding the weight of their head, so place them right up against the backwash basin and tilt their head back onto the headbed. Ask them, is your neck comfortable? If not really, then encourage them to adjust their position until perfectly comfortable before you start. If you get a confident yes, then proceed. No need to have the towel so high up the neck anymore. Tuck the towel down and out of the way so that the client's skin is against the headbed cushion. This creates a perfect seal against the skin for easy color removal and no leakage. When removing a color, emulsify at the nape of the neck first and wipe off excess tint. Then get the client to recline back comfortably and you can work more easily with the client's head in the optimal position and no strain on her neck. In a deep basin without a headbed, the client's head drops back sharply, making the nape harder to reach. See the color trapped at the top of the headbed, proving a perfect seal and no leakage down the neck. Wipe this off to avoid putting color back on the client's skin before proceeding with your rinsing and shampoo. As your client's head is further back and more inside the basin, it assists you in rinsing off the products. Many clients tend to sit lower at the wash basin in an attempt to straighten their uncomfortable neck, but not anymore with headbed. They can relax their head back, making your job a lot easier. To rinse off the last 3% of the hair, gently tilt the head to one side slightly, rinse, and do the same for the other side. And as usual, place your hand under and up the back of the nape. Tell your client, you will lift their head. No need for them to help and strain up. When you are shampooing, the pressure you put on the downward stroke no longer causes extra strain on the client's neck, as the head is supported by the headbed. The same applies with the massage strokes. Without a headbed, see how the head tilts back and the neck takes the strain.
Everybody loves idea of a scalp massage, but unfortunately, if their neck's aching by now...
Yes. They're just begging to get out of the basin.
Some clients feel no strain at the backwash basin, but plenty do. How would you know who has a potential health problem and could get hurt? Even at the drying and toweling stage, the headbed is there to support the head and so protect the neck from too much strain. To finish, make sure you lift the client's head out of the basin. This is all about our client's comfort and safety, first and foremost. We owe it to them to learn how to use a headbed at our backwash basins, a small but important change for a better future.